wanting exposure to a market or an
everything
asset.
They need in one place.
Be the world's foremost authority on mutuals, advisors and institutions.
Hello and welcome to the Morningstar series, Market Reaction. I'm Emma Wall and here with me today is Didier Saint-Georges from Carmignac.
Hello, Didier.
Hello.
So you're here today to give us a global market outlook. I thought we'd start with perhaps the region you're most familiar with, which is Europe. A lot of change with the ECB announcing some measures recently. How will this affect markets?
Well, it was a really high time that Mr. Draghi would really try to do something powerful. We have to remember that he's talked a lot so far, but he hasn't acted that much. So that's a good beginning, but it's going to take more to get the European economy going.
So you think these measures aren't going to be enough to kickstart growth?
No, they're not going to be enough. You know, clearly the momentum of the European economies is very slow right now. It will take more action from the BCE, from the ECB, to really get the economy going.
So what will it take then?
Well, probably it will take the first measures to have an impact already on the behavior of banks, maybe instillate some confidence so that the borrowers start borrowing a bit more, and then he would be able to move on to new measures, like possibly a real form of European quantitative easing.
And these measures, making it easier and cheaper for banks to borrow money so they can lend it out, that will again have an impact on markets, won't it? Because if businesses are able to borrow money, surely that means good things for equities.
Yeah, it's almost the other way around, in the sense that what Mr. Draghi is doing is clearly good for the banks. Will be good for financial assets. There's a reflation of financial assets. The extent to which it will be good for the real economy will depend on the appetite for more debt, more borrowing, and that is very unsure for the time being. So, Mr. Draghi, clearly we have an effect on the supply side, but the demand side is not within his scope.
And what then, turning to the US, this has been quite an interesting year for the US. The first 3 months were pretty dire, having to massively downgrade growth forecasts because of this one-off weather event. Or was it just down to the one-off weather event? What's going on there?
I think we have a case of an economy which is, of course, doing a lot better than the European economy, but it's still a weak recovery. And I think this uncertainty about quarterly performance not only says a lot about how reliable official statistics can be, but also it says a lot about how fragile the US economy is. So it is sending a message to Janet Yellen that she should be careful before tightening.
And quantitative easing obviously is coming to an end over there. Do you think as that tapers down, we will start to see these interest rate rises? Or do you think as you offer there, perhaps there'll be a bit of a wait?
Now, there will be a wait. The question is how much? Our opinion is that the US economy is not that strong that Janet Yellen should take the risk of tightening too early. It looks like, according to the posture that she's taken so far, that she will be more tempted to take the risk of tightening too late rather than take the risk of tightening too early.
And while she's fiddling about with what's going on in the economy, the markets are doing extremely well in the US, aren't they? I mean, there's very much a disconnect between perhaps a slightly weaker economy and a fantastic stock market.
Yeah, absolutely. You could make that case also for Europe, because the discrepancy is even more striking. In the US, at least, there is some momentum in the real economy. And the tapering so far has been well absorbed by the economy, really, at the end of the day. So, for the time being, the profile of the US economy and the US market is more reassuring than it is in Europe.
I mean, talking about tapering, that brings us quite nicely onto emerging markets, because it wasn't just the US that was affected when Ben Bernanke said that tapering would happen. Emerging markets massively sold off. How are emerging markets looking today, a year on?
Yeah, that has been, you're absolutely right. It's been the major feature last year. It looked like the tapering would have a major effect on global liquidity and therefore on emerging markets. 1 year later, quite reassuringly, this tapering hasn't had such a big effect on liquidity, and emerging markets have done quite well during that period. I think it is making the case for at least some emerging economies to be sort of standing on their own feet, and even with a tapering, by their own efforts, those economies have continued to do quite well, and therefore the markets. It's the case for India, it's the case for Mexico, it's also the case of China, that are doing, you know, making progress every quarter despite this tapering.
That's because at least two of those have had new governments, haven't they, which are putting policies in place which are helping to instill economic growth.
No, absolutely. It's both a case of reforms, of the governments doing the right things. It's also a case of economic cycle. In India, Mr. Modi is doing the right things, but also happens to have some tailwind. You know, the economic cycle is moving up in India. The second quarter was the strongest quarter in terms of economic growth for the past 3 years. So when you have governments doing the right things and the economic cycle improving, you know, surely, you know, it paves the way for pretty healthy markets.
Didier, thank you very much.
Thank you.
This is Emma Wall for Morningstar. Thank you for watching.